Hello and welcome viewers and subscribers of AVG News. Mxolisi, the son of Ncube, is my name, and I hope I find you well. It's been a long while since we last posted something on this channel, but because of a number of other issues, I've decided that we should start updating you. You'll see that I have changed the background of where I am. That is because we are still trying to set up a new studio somewhere, and I'm recording as it is from home, so you'll have to bear with me on that. I want to address some questions that have been filtered to me for a number of weeks now pertaining to Zimbabwe exemption permit holders who want to sojourn to any other South African visa. And the two main questions that I want to address right now concern whether or not the waiver is still required for those who want to move to the general work visa or the Zimbabwe, the exemption that you know that there is a new exemption that expires next year in November. So people are asking if they still need the waiver. As I've explained before, you only need the waiver if you are applying for a general work visa or a critical skills visa but do not meet the requirements that are set out in the Immigration Act. Perhaps you have a critical skill but you don't meet the NQF level that is set out in the Immigration Act. You will need a waiver in order for you to then apply for that particular critical skills visa. If you want a general work visa and you are doing general work but you don't have certain qualifications or you don't meet certain requirements, you do need a waiver. This is crystal clear. It was said by the spokesperson of the Minister of Home Affairs, that is Mr. Dwayne Esau, in a conversation that I had with him a few months ago. Nothing has changed. But if you are applying for a Zimbabwe exemption, that is the one that expires in November next year, you don't need a waiver. You go straight to that particular permit and apply for it. Then you go and submit your documents and await the outcome. So we don't know what is going to happen after the expiry of that exemption, but what we know for certain is that there are going to be consultations by the minister with the relevant stakeholders before they can decide on whether or not to completely cancel the ZEP extension or to give people another option to continue being legal in South Africa. But what we know for certain is that people will not be criminalized. A solution is going to be found. And then the second question is, can someone who has applied and obtained an exemption then also change and apply for a waiver and a general work visa? I will repeat the question again. There are people who applied for the Zimbabwe exemption permit, the one that expires next year, and now they believe that they've made a mistake and they are asking if they can apply for a waiver while they hold that exemption which expires next year. Can they apply for a waiver and after having been granted that waiver then sojourn to the general work visa? The answer is a crystal clear no. You cannot. Once you have applied for an exemption, you cannot change to then apply for a general, for a waiver and then general work visa. I'm not making this up. It also came out of my conversation with Mr. Dwayne Esau, who is the spokesperson for the Minister of Home Affairs, and I'm going to read his statement as it is. If a Zimbabwe exemption has been applied for, no change to a waiver and then general work visa can be done. If a Zimbabwe exemption had been applied for, no change to a waiver and then general work visa can be done. So it means you cannot. You choose either the Zimbabwe exemption or a waiver, then general work visa. So I've been told that some people have been made to believe that they can then apply for a waiver even if they've applied for an exemption. You cannot do that. So you have to await the expiry or the next communication that is going to come from the Department of Home Affairs on what is going to happen after the expiry of that exemption. I hope I've addressed that. If you still have any more questions, we are back available now. You can use the comment section under this, underneath this video, or WhatsApp me on +27 73 962 3075. Don't call, don't send voice notes, just send a text message. Thank you very much. Meet you in the next broadcast.